Hi everyone, welcome back to our new session of the UiPath. So in this session I will explain you how to update our defect by using UiPath in Jira. So we have seen that Jira is basically used for the test case management and defect reporting, and it is integrated with UiPath because of the test suite or test manager, which is introduced by the UiPath forum. So this is a very advanced feature which is used for the testing, and rather than logging or updating or deleting the defect manually, we can do it through automation. So I will explain here how to update the defect by using UiPath tool in Jira. So let's begin with this. So for that we need one Jira account, and some defects are already logged in. So you can see I already logged here 4-5 defects here. So if I want to update any of the defect manually, I need to go to login into that account, and after login I have to open the defect number and update manually. But skipping that process and doing through automation, it's very easy to do that. And next thing, we will need to have the API token. So let's come to here in the activity panel. So for those who did not install the Jira activities, download it through your dependency tab and install that, and go to Jira get, drag Jira get application scope. In Jira get application scope, we need to configure token API, and we will get that token API from here. So if you have not created your token API, just click on the create API token and enter your label. After entering your label, you just have to press save button. After pressing save button, you will get a token API. Copy that token API and paste it to here. So I will show you the link as well, how we'll go to that. Just go to id.atlassian.com/manage/api-tokens. So once you will enter, you can see same screen is available here as well. Okay, now after configuring this, the token API, we need to configure our username. You can see here your username. So whatever username you are using to log in the Jira account, enter same username, and endpoint we have to enter it from here. So you can see here from HTTPS to net, you have to copy this and paste it to here. Now after doing all this, just have to click on the test connection. You can see valid connection is done. Now next activity, we are going to use update issues. So update issues are also available in the same Jira get activity. Inside that Jira get activity, drag and drop this activity and enter here the key or the defect number. So let's say I want to update defect number UTP1. So I need to mention here the defect number UTP1. Okay, next we need to configure parameters. So which all parameters are required to update. So if you want to take a help from the get example data, you can just click on this and just say I want to update description and summary tab. So I am writing here as a summary. Now you can see summary is available here as, let me add one more thing, description as well. Once you will click double click, the both the contents are available here. Let me close this. Now both the tabs are available. So let's see here The summary tab is available. Calling feature is not available. Auto to. Let me copy this and we'll make the changes here. And the description is, this is the additional description to automation command. I have already executed, because of that this is the description. Let us change the description through automation script. I copied here and let me change to automation to automation 3, or you can say 4. So let me write here the other type of description. As you can see, this is the additional description through automation command. This description is already available, so we need to change that description. So this is this description through automation channel or automation command 4. Click run command. Once you will click run command, you can see valid command and execute it simply. Refresh your defect page and you will see that summary and description tab is updated successfully in Jira as well. You can see calling feature is not available, automation 4, before it was 2, and the description through automation command 4. These two field we have updated. So let's see other fields also. If you want to update priority as well, just leave priority. So let me update this priority, and my defect priority is high, so I am giving here as a medium. Now run the command again. Because we have already updated these two fields, let me execute only single command. Medium fields priority. Let's see, we'll take another example. Think it's hanged. Hang now. Yeah, let me open it again. Medium. Or we'll select some other fields like resolution. Resolve. Let me delete this. Run command. We are getting some errors. Resolve. So let me check in the description tab what is available. So 7 more fields. We need to enter some other fields also, because of that it's showing some errors. So let me select any fields that is not having any dependency to that. So let me select label. Label. Yes. So label is critical defect. Let's select this. If it is not having any dependency, it will run successfully, because whenever we are entering label, it should be already defined and same level we are proceeding with here. So we need to make sure that whatever we are updating, that same field is available in any of the channel. So let's say to update any environment, yes, it might update. Let me check here as well, because environment is also dependent from the other tab. Let me run this. This is also not available. So whatever field it is required or not having dependent, that same field will update it through here, otherwise it will not work. So this is all about how to update issues or defect in UI in Jira through automation tool using by UiPath. This is all about updating the issue. Hope you understand it. If you have any queries or comment, please comment in the comment section so that I will check and revert with the resolution. And don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.